Men's Kirin is the last of the medals to be decided on the track program here at Rio in 2016. The start list, the position 7th to 12th, Glatzer, de Almeida, Purvis, Polikarkas, Webster and Maxell. The race for 7th to 12th in the men's Kirin. And there are six riders: Matt Glatzer, Michael de Almeida, Francois Purvis, Christos Polikarkas, Sam Webster and Christoph Maxell.
The pacing bike goes past. He'll start out the first lap at 30 kilometers per hour. Over the next 5.5 laps, lift the pace to 50 kilometers per hour. And when he peels off, these riders will start their fight, lifting speed to speeds of over 70 kilometers per hour in the men's Kirin event. You see Matt Glatzer, the Australian, he had a fall as they went off the line. Restart now. Seemed to have a little bit of an issue with his wrist. We'll see if that plays a part in this final for 7th to 12th place. Sam Webster, the New Zealander, he takes the pacing bike.
And that bike increasing in speed. Two Frenchmen, a Pole, a Greek, and then it's the Australian at the back. So at the moment, it is Webster, then Purvis, then Maxell, the Polish rider, Christos Polikarkas from Greece. The other Frenchman in the field is Michael de Almeida there, second last, and bringing up the rear, Matt Glatzer.
Well, it's going to be an exciting race here. Sam Webster very, very focused on that pacing bike. All these riders visualizing what's going to happen when the pacing bike comes off the track. This is the calm before the storm. They'll start to look over their shoulders in a minute to see where their competitors are placed in this line of riders. Pace picking up every lap.
Such a low position. Glatzer at the back there, beautifully positioned. As Webster looks up, he'll see on the big screen, and he looks back behind him to see what's happening. There's a gap left by Maxell there.
The New Zealander Sam Webster, he'll be watching to take advantage of those gaps, and the rider's laying off the wheels. He applies some pressure now, picks up the speed.
It's Purvis is in fact a de Almeida chasing down Webster now.
Oh, Webster hits out early, still got a lap to go as they come around to get the bell. Sam Webster, a strong ride so far, but he's been out there for a long time. Can he hold off the Frenchman? He's going to have tired legs coming into the final bend. And here comes the fight from the Frenchman, Sam Webster. Oh, did he hold on?
I think he might have held on there. De Almeida, I think, was in second place. I think that Sam Webster of New Zealand managed to hold on. So 7th to 12th place, Sam Webster, Michael De Almeida, and Maxell Glatzer, Purvis and Polikarkas complete the race and complete their program at the Olympic Games. Fabian Puerta of Colombia, Jason Kenny from Great Britain, Joachim Ellers, the world champion, Azia Wang from Malaysia, Matthias Buckley and Damian Zielinski complete the field.
For a third start in this men's Kirin final, the tension is high.
Well, imagine what's going on in the bodies of these athletes, primed and prepared for an Olympic gold medal race. This is the third time they will come up to the start line. Joachim Ellers, Damian Zielinski, Matthias Buckley, Jason Kenny, Aziza Wang and Fabian Puerta. Could not possibly be more tense at the start now after two restarts. This is the third.
Oh, they need to refocus now, put everything out of their minds. It's the Olympic gold medal final of the men's Kirin. Third time they've tried to start this competition. Here comes the pacing bike.
The men's gold medal race in the Kirin is underway. After two starts, this is a third restart. And a packed field of the very best Kieran riders is rolling out behind the Durney. Wang, Piotr, Kenny, Buckley, Zielinski, and the world champion right at the back, as he has been throughout, Joachim Eilers.
Well, we're going to see some hesitation when that pacing bike comes off the track. They've had a couple of warnings from the commissaire.
Wang prefers this position right behind the Durney. Piotr wanted to be there, but Wang has that position.
Well, this time the Colombian settles for second position. We've seen Jason Kenny position in third wheel all three times they've started this Kieran final. And we've seen Joachim Eilers, the reigning world champion of the Kieran, always wanting to ride from the back and make a jump when the pacing bike rolls off the track.
Speed increasing, tension rising amongst these riders. It was when the Durney pulled over on the first two races that infringements occurred. Riders getting ahead of the back wheel, overlapping the back wheel of the Durney. They'll be well aware of this as they come around now. This will be the last time the bike goes past the coaches. A little bit of movement behind Wang.
Oh, they're giving some safe distance off that pacing bike this time. And it's Jason Kenny and Joachim Eilers now moving to the front. The reigning world champion takes control of the sprint lane. Jason Kenny just struggling a bit now.
Zielinski goes for Poland on the front now. Eilers in second place, Kenny in third, Wang, Buckley and Piotr. Damian Zielinski will take them through the bell in the lead here. Joachim Eilers, the world champion, is going to race him round this last lap. Jason Kenny is keeping himself in the picture.
Here comes Jason Kenny with a late run. Is he going to get there over Joachim Eilers? It looks like he is. Great Britain takes the gold medal in the men's Kieran.
Jason Kenny does it again. A sixth gold medal for Jason Kenny.
Oh, Laura Trotti's fiance in the inside of the track. She can't believe it. These riders, five gold medals between them here at the Rio Olympic Games. Jason Kenny, what a ride. He was so relaxed there. Laid off the wheel, gave plenty of distance with a late run, and the coach, he can't believe it.
His first in the Kieran. Jason Kenny gets the gold medal. Mateus Buckley, the silver. And Aziz Awang from Malaysia gets the bronze medal.
Well, Awang from Malaysia, he can't believe it. A bronze medal at the Olympic Games. Shaking his head, full of emotion, the rider from Malaysia.
We'll add this to the gold medal of Laura Trott in the Omnium and the team pursuit. Sprint gold, team sprint gold, and Kieran gold for Jason Kenny. An absolutely thrilling culmination to 6 days of wonderful action inside the velodrome.
Wow, look how close that is in the Olympic Kieran final. Certainly going to be busy over the next 6 to 12 months with the attention from all the Great Britain fans that have been behind Jason Kenny since his victory in 2012 in London in front of a home crowd, and a superb ride in the Kieran here in Rio.
Jason Kenny gold, Mateus Buckley silver, and Azizul Hasni Awang from Malaysia, the bronze. They've never won a gold medal. They've won silver and bronze medals in badminton and diving, but never in the velodrome.
Medalha de ouro e campeão olímpico, representando a Grã-Bretanha, Jason Kenny!
Jason Kenny, a six-time Olympic champion. He's 28, and he is only the fourth man to win the Kieran. It's been part of the program since 2000, and he follows in the footsteps of the great Chris Hoy, who won it in 2008 and 2012. as the Olympic champion. Huge support for the British team here, and he's given them rich reward for their efforts to get to the velodrome in Rio. Six gold medals. He joins Sir Chris Hoy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the on that Olympic number. Medalists.
Senhoras e senhores, os medalhistas olímpicos.
And surely it will be Sir Jason Kenny very shortly. Matthias Buckley, the silver medalist, and a wonderful bronze for Azizul Hasni Awang from Malaysia.